friends, welcome to my channel. So we are today in Trivandrum Zoo, and it is in the middle of the city Trivandrum, which is situated in Kerala, India. So let me show you what's in here, and I hope you like it. And we are going to see this place today. This is the main entrance of both zoo and the napiermuseum complex, and let's see what's in it. The zoo contains around 55 acres of woodland, lakes and lawns, and the whole complex was open to the public during the year 1857. So I have been here for many times from my childhood itself, but today I'm with my friends, two of my friends, and I'm gonna show you the entire complex here. And in this video we are gonna see, but the next video is all about the museum, so stay tuned. And this is the main entrance of the zoo, which is situated inside the Napier Museum complex. And the entrance we saw before is the main entrance for both zoo and the museum. So if you want to get inside, then you have to pay a ticket charge of around rupees 20 for an adult, and there is a package like we have to pay a little less for a man, a woman and a two children, like a family package, and some discount for a group of people less than 35 or something. And you have to be here on any day, but you cannot go inside on Mondays. So note that Monday is a holiday for the zoological park in Trivandrum. So officially we are inside the zoological park, and this is what you are going to see when you are inside the park at the entrance. And there is a kind of bunkie available if you don't want to walk around for 55 acres, but I am willing to walk, and it is the coolest park of this botanical or the zoological garden. So we are going to walk around and see all the animals. And when I searched the Wikipedia, it was said that there is around 82 species of animals inside this park, and I have seen almost every animal when I came before. And it's also said that it is one of the oldest of the zoos in India, so I think this rupees 20 is really worth for money. The first one whom you are going to be welcomed by is the monkeys. It's called the lion-tailed macaque, and this is the space for that species, but I can see only two of them. And on this side there is a cage or a space for the bison, and this is the entrance through which we came inside. And this is the cage for the bisons, and it is a large animal, and I'm really very poor in recognizing the species and animals, so I used to read all the descriptions given there. So if you want, you can also do that. And this is the Indian bison, and this is the cage for the lion-tailed macaque, and I can see only one of them here. And when I last came, there was a lot many species of monkeys in the entrance itself, the common monkey, the common langur, etc., but there's nothing. And this is the trench, and it's for the safety purpose, so that these animals cannot come over to us, or they cannot escape from here or just come out and attack us on when we come to see them. But compared to the other zoos I have seen all around the world, it's like we can just interact to the animals, go near them, feed them, etc. in other zoos internationally, but in Indian zoos, especially in Trivandrum, it's not possible. It's the December month, and it's the starting of December, like 4th of the December today, but you can see it's really sunny here. There's nothing like a chilling climate, and it's really hot and humid, and I cannot tolerate the sun, and that's why all the video is kind of blurred or like kind of foggy or something. And if you are a foreigner or something and you are expecting something like a snowfall or something like a chill climate to come to Kerala, then you cannot expect that in Kerala. In Kerala, December can be either a kind of chilly or like this. The place is really beautiful with all this greenery and all the green canopy. So if you're interested to walk in the nature without going into the forest, then this is really beautiful place in the middle of the city. So if you want to visit here, you have to come by 9 a.m. in the morning so you can walk around the 55 acres of land and enjoy the nature. And you have to go out by 5 p.m. because it closes at 5 p.m. Inside the cage, there's beautiful birds inside, but it's really hard to see and it's really hard to capture with my camera and my phone. So there are so much beautiful birds and they look like the stuffed birds, and I hope you can appreciate them. And it's early in the morning and the birds and the animals are not that active, and some of the birds are sitting somewhere in the top part of this cage, so it's really hard for us to see or to capture them. This place is seriously beautiful with all kind of plants and animals, and I hope you could hear the voice. And I'm going to show you some more animals here. Actually, I don't know which animal is in this place. It's actually a cage for some animal, and there's a huge trench over here so that no animal could escape from here. So we have a maximum protection even though it's in the middle of the city. We can hear so much noises etc. from the city, but mostly this place is really calm and quiet, really beautiful. If you want to enjoy your time in nature, then you better come to this place rather than going to some other area. And in Kerala there is only two zoos, and one is here and the other is in Trissur. I think this place belongs to this common language, but I don't see anyone here. Maybe he's in some of the trees. Maybe you can spot him. Maybe he's asleep. These two are my friends, so we are here together, so you can see them also in my videos. See the thick canopy over here, so thick and green.
I was expecting 82 species of animals and birds inside these cages, but it's kind of literally empty inside the zoo. It's an empty zoo without any animals or birds. The elephants are gone, the giraffe is gone, the leopard is gone, and there is only a small amount of birds and animals left inside here. So I don't know what happened to them. They were all before here, before the COVID, and there is nobody literally in here after the COVID. And if anyone responsible for the museum or the zoo is watching my video, please take care or take note and do something, because I don't want to see this zoo in this situation, in this pathetic way, without any animals or birds. Because they have converted an artificial lake entirely into a separate habitat by growing green algae all around the lake, so that some kind of birds and animals and some plants, even fishes, where some species gets benefit from there, and it's protected like that. And the entire place looks like there is a green velvet coating or a carpet on the ground, and the place is covered by glass all around, so we can just rest here and see all the beautiful happenings inside the glass pool, and it's really awesome. Contains many tunnels like this with glass windows, so we can see what's happening inside those cages. But the cage is literally empty, so don't know what was going on before here. And let's move on to some history. This place was made like this all because of the Travancore king, who is known as Swati Tirunal Rama Verma, 1830 to 1846. He had a good collection of animals, including elephants, in his horse breeding center, and he had tigers, cheetahs, langurs, deers, bears, and a lioness. So he had given all these animals to his brother. He is called Uttram Tirunal Marthanda Verma. And Along with the British resident General Cullen, they both made this into a zoological park, and at first it was just a museum, and they found that just the museum was not that attractable to the public, so they made this into a zoo also, and this thing was open to the public in September 1857, and now this is under the control of the state government and the central zoo authority. And at first it was all the caged animals, like the animals was all behind the bars, and now they thought it was just for a kind of entertainment or something. And then they found out that all the habitats, the forest is getting destroyed, and there is a need for protection of all these animals, so they converted it into this kind of forest like habitats and more naturalistic habitats. This is my most favorite part in the zoo, and this is the section for all the large animals like tigers, then leopards, then cheetahs and all, but currently there is only two royal Bengal tigers and one Siberian tiger, white tiger, and there is nothing else. The lion is gone, the lioness is gone, the cheetah is gone, and nothing at all. And I don't know what happened to all of them, but it's really cool to see them walk around in the cages like this, but seriously I want to go and touch them and be with them, feed them and all, like what we can do in some other zoos of some other countries like the United Arab Emirates, California, etc. But it's really pathetic, we cannot go near them. And but there is places where we can see them live, and they are the wildlife sanctuaries, and there's plenty of them in Kerala. And if you want to come and see them, then just go to Google and search for those places, and there is so much beautiful places in Kerala where you can see the live animals. And this is the white Siberian tiger, and it's kind of looking like the Royal Bengal tiger, which has been painted white, and it's seriously beautiful. Last time I have visited here, I have been welcomed by a large amount of peacocks. I have even seen dancing peacocks, but there's nothing here, just two or three of them now. This part of the park is a new one, and there's so much of flowering plants for welcoming all the butterflies, but seriously I don't see anything here, just a few amount of smaller ones and a larger one which I was kind of chasing to capture, but I couldn't get because it was too fast and it just went away. But I like this cool bridge because it's really awesome for making my photos, and if you want to see my photos then you have to be in my Instagram page, but it's not open for all the public, it's a private page. And I have another page, it's solely meant for all the henna work I used to do, and it's called Mehndi Love. And For all the travel videos and photos, I have another page and it's called A Traveler's Memories, and I do have a blog where I write all my travel experiences and it's called A Traveler's Memories. wordpress.com. You can Google that if you are interested. And this is my YouTube channel. It was solely meant for all my henna work, but this is my first travel video, and from today we are going to include a lot much of travel videos. And the thing is that the travel videos will be having a yellow border for the thumbnail, and for the henna videos a blue border. This is the reptile park, and it is the most hated place of mine inside the zoo, because I am seriously too afraid of all these reptiles, especially snakes. And I just got inside only because I want to film this for you. Otherwise, I would have never gone inside this, because it contains all large, small snakes and it's so creepy. But I like this cage because it contains loads and loads of turtles, and in one of the cage I have found a smaller one, a baby turtle, and this is the eel fish, and it seems like it's dead, and I was like, oh, it's dead, and the auntie near me like, no, it's not dead, it's sleeping, and I was like, oh, thank you. Baby turtle spotted. This was the baby turtle I was seeing before, but I have seen a smaller one in some other cage, and it's seriously so cute. It's just like a cute turtle out there, and I think it's the baby of that larger one because it's swimming near him, and it's so cute. Have you ever been to the movie Anaconda? Then look into this cage, and here is a hero resting there peacefully. This is the green anaconda, the man-eater. The man-eater snake is inside the trivandrumzoo, and if you are a fan of that movie, then just come here and see him. It's all here, and I'm so afraid to see him, and I don't want to see him. Thank you. So this is the last session of the Trivandrum Zoo, and we are gonna go outside, and this pretty lady is gonna say bye bye to us. She's really a kind of poser, and she's like, let me come into your filming and let me make a pose. And she's gonna posing for all my videos and photos, and I seriously like this birdie. So thank you guys for watching my video, and see you in my next video. So if you didn't subscribe to my channel, subscribe to my channel and press the bell button below, and see you in my next video. Bye.